episode of Tekzilla is sponsored by Citrix ShareFile. We got a ton of people asking about installing Linux on a Chromebook, so today we're going to show you how! Now that I've actually done this and discovered how easy it is, I'm seriously considering buying a Chromebook as my new Linux PC because it actually works and it's good at it and it's nice and stable.
So which distro did you choose?
Ubuntu, but there are several that you can choose from. There's actually a couple of really good tutorials online. There's one over at lifehacker.com. It's how to install Linux on a Chromebook and unlock its full potential. There's also a really good listing over here, how to install Linux on an Acer C720 Chromebook. So this is the one that I actually used for mine. And down at the bottom, they also include information on how to install a different kind of Linux operating system called Body Linux. First off, there's quite a few instructions that you need to follow, because if you don't follow these, you'll probably break your operating system. So first off, you need to create some kind of recovery media drive, just in case you end up screwing up Linux in the process. Yes, sir.
The recovery media drive could also be useful if you want to reinstall Chrome
Absolutely.
Back on the Chromebook.
Yes, okay. That's very true. Now I'm kind of doing a dual boot process thing here, more on that in a little bit, but first off, yes, this is very, very handy. You really need to have that recovery media drive. Just use a little flash drive. Make sure it's at least 2 gigs in size, just in case you need to reinstall Chrome operating system on your Chromebook. So first off, you need to find the model of your Chromebook. To do this, what you'll do is turn off your Chromebook and then hold down Escape and F3. F3 is actually a little refresh. It looks like a little circle with a refresh arrow on it. So you hold those down, you hit power, and then it'll bring you to a nice little screen that shows your model number at the bottom. So write down that model number. And then what you'll want to do is continue from there. You're going to restart Chromebook into just its normal mode. Now you can create your recovery drive. This is pretty simple. You just go to Chrome:// image burner. Now from here, you just follow the on-screen instructions to actually make it. You click the accept button, you wait for your new recovery image to download and burn onto the flash drive. This will probably take about 10 to 15 minutes for it to actually finish. If it doesn't work, if it's just sticking there for like an hour, you might want to use a Chrome OS recovery tool. So for Acer specifically, they actually link to a recovery tool that was created by Google. Right here, the Chrome OS recovery tool. So that's what I would use in the off chance that the one that's built into the Chromebook doesn't work. And then you just follow the on-screen instructions for that as well. So you need to turn off your Chromebook if it's not already off, and then hold Escape and refresh one more time and tap power until it powers on. You'll get back to that same model number screen. When it hits that, hit Control and D at the same time and press Enter. This is going to take you into this new screen, which is called the developer mode. So you need to set up a wireless connection and then accept the EULA, but don't log in. It's going to ask you to log into your Google account, just don't do it. From here, you'll need to press Control, Alt, and the arrow at the very top, which is usually an F key, but it's up at the top, so it's a little right arrow. Type in Chronos and then hit Enter. So this is what you should get. You should get a screen that looks like a terminal. And down at the bottom, it'll say localhost login. So down here, I'm gonna type in Chronos. Hit Enter, and you should get what looks like a terminal mode on a regular Linux laptop. So from here, and this looks a little scary, but I'll explain what it means. This is the command that you actually have to type in. So I'm gonna type this in real quick, goo.gl/9sghs:/sudo bash. And this probably looks familiar if you've used any terminal commands before in the past.
What's a bash?
What is a bash? So first off, curl. Curl is a command tool that lets you transfer data via a URL syntax. TACL is for the location of whatever data you're transferring. TACO-O writes that remote name to a local file so that 9sghs, that file right there, it's going to transfer that to a local file. And the next is the file URL, the link of that file that it's going to transfer locally. Sudo bash and then the same file is actually putting it into a local file in super user.
Cool.
Ta-da! Yeah, so it's all just in that one little command right there. So I'm not gonna hit enter because I've already done this, but after this, it's gonna ask you to choose the Ubuntu operating system size. I made mine 24 gigs because this has plenty of room on the actual drive inside here. You can make it anywhere between like 10 and 24 if you want to. Some of them, I know some Chromebooks have like 8 gigs or like 16 gigs of memory size on them, so you might wanna bring it down to like 10 gigs. Ubuntu totally is, I think, about 8 gigs, so you have plenty of space to use. That extra gigabyte size is going to be specifically for any files that you wanna save in Ubuntu. So it's gonna restart again. You'll have to go back into dev mode again with Control Alt in that little right arrow. This installation does take some time, so just wait for it. You know, drink a nice little coffee like Patrick has here, or just wait and let it prompt you for anything that it might ask you to do on screen. Just hit yes a few times, very easy. Upon reboot, now you should be done. It does take about half an hour to actually get through the entire process, but I'm gonna go ahead and reboot my computer one more time to show you that I can get into both operating systems. Okay, so it says OS verification is off. I'm gonna hit Control L, and now what it's going to do is boot into Ubuntu. Now, if you still want to get into Chrome, you can also hit Control D, and that'll automatically get you back into Chrome. So you have both choices there. When you download Ubuntu, when you have it all installed, it's going to ask you for a username and password too. Those are just user and user, U-S-E-R and U-S-E-R. Okay, so my Ubuntu system just booted up, so you can see that I have a desktop running. I have my mirror displayed, so you can actually see it on screen. Ta-da! Now, I'm not connected to the internet right now, but everything works like it normally does. So it sees all the local networks that are around me. So I can easily connect, I can browse the web, I can watch Netflix on it. Netflix runs really, really well on here. I can boot into either Ubuntu or Chrome OS. That's what makes me really enjoy this, because what if I still want to use Chrome OS for something? This is kind of dual booting, but not. It basically creates a virtual instance of Ubuntu within Chrome OS. And it's been very, very stable on multiple reboots. I haven't had anything break with this since I did it like a week ago. So fun.
We should also point out that this is a Core i3, this Acer Chromebook that we did this on, or you did this on. I just sort of stared and made supportive noises. Is a Core i3, which is pretty powerful for a Chromebook. And if you're dealing with ARM, things might be a little more complicated.
That's true. I would recommend, in that case, using the Boti Linux, which we linked to. That one's very minimalist. It has a lot of good reviews as far as downloading it onto other Chromebooks. You can also install using a tool called Crouton, which is C-R-O-U-T-O-N, or another one called Crubuntu, which is C-H-R-Ubuntu. Both of those are made specifically to put Ubuntu onto your operating system on your Chromebook.
Yay. As
with any other operating system, of course, be really, really careful and make sure you read all of the directions before you even start, because they, wherever you might find a tutorial, they may just mention something at the very end, like how I did just now and said, read all the directions before you start.
And back up, please.
But it's fun. I hope you guys enjoy it as much as I did. It's so cool.
You're so excited.
I'm seriously considering buying one of these now. I'm like, yay, it's an i3 and it has Linux on it. I could do hacks. I could put my RTL SDR in here and listen to radio airplanes.
Ladies and gentlemen, I don't know if Shannon's going to be as excited for the rest of the show, but there is more Tekzilla coming up, so stay tuned. But before we do that, let's take a moment to thank one of our sponsors.
When you buy a domain from domain.com, you get the power to influence and control what people find when they search for you online. No other domain extensions tell your story with the same trust of a .com or a .net domain name. .com and .net domain extensions inject credibility into your online presence, and who doesn't want to be credible? We like domain.com because they're affordable, they're reliable, and they're super easy to use. A .com domain is only $9.99 per year, and a .net is only $8.99 per year. Plus, the folks at domain.com gave Tekzilla an awesome offer for even more savings. You can get 20% off domain.com's already affordable domain names and web hosting when you use the coupon code Tekzilla at checkout. That's 20% off, aka big time savings. Don't forget to use the coupon code Tekzilla. And when you think domain names, think domain.com.